The early voters will also help decide a series of very important Senate races. In Kentucky, Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell faced his Democratic challenger, that's Amy McGrath, in a TV debate last night. Ed O'Keefe looks at some of the races that are heating up with just 3 weeks to go.
You negotiate, Senator. It is a national crisis. Yeah.
The response to the coronavirus pandemic and the Supreme Court nomination took center stage in Kentucky last night.
No one believes the Supreme Court is going to strike down the Affordable Care Act.
Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell is still hugely popular in the state, where he's leading Democrat Amy McGrath by double digits in the latest polling. But McGrath has outpaced McConnell in fundraising, with more than $47 million to his roughly $37
million. This is about what can we do to improve the state.
Money is also flooding into another Southern race. Democrat Jamie Harrison is neck and neck with Republican Senator Lindsey Graham in South Carolina. Harrison reported raising a record-breaking $57 million in the last quarter, prompting pleas like this one from the incumbent.
There's not enough money to flip this state. I do need to fight back.
And in Arizona,
we're in this together.
Republican Senator Martha McSally faces Democrat Mark Kelly, a former astronaut and the husband of former Congresswoman Gabrielle Giffords. A recent poll shows Kelly leading McSally by 10 points.
There are several other races to keep your eye on. Down in North Carolina, Democrat Cal Cunningham remains ahead of Republican Senator Tom Tillis, despite recent revelations about an extramarital affair. In Alabama, Democratic Senator Doug Jones is facing popular former college football coach and Republican Tommy Tuberville in the seat Democrats are most at risk of losing. And in Maine, Republican Senator Susan Collins is facing a tough challenge from Democrat Sarah Gideon. Collins is facing a barrage of attack ads tied partly to her support for Supreme Court Justice Brett Kavanaugh back in 2018. The numbers to remember this morning. There are 35 Senate seats up for grabs. Republicans are defending 23 of them. They have a 53-47 majority. Democrats, if they want to win back control, they need to net 3 seats. If Joe Biden wins the White House, 4 seats. If President Trump does. Anthony, it's going to be a quiz.
Thanks, Ed. I'm taking notes.
He will pass, too. And Anthony Mason will pass Ed O'Keefe.
Yes, he will.
Bring it on.
And how many days till the election, Ed? Well, you don't have your sign behind you today.
3 weeks to go. I checked it this morning before I left.
All right. Thanks, Ed.